Being a developer can be boring at times. I mean, what happens after you've done it all? What happens when you've built everything there is to build? Breaking React Native, is it even possible? I had to find ideas, experiments I could do to make an app break. I had to be creative. So, here's the plan. I will create a button that moves all around the screen and it will randomly go into any direction within the screen size. For this, I have a flying button component that is an animated view which should go in one direction then another every 500 milliseconds. So I have these two animated values, left and top, that will be set to random values and animated so the whole view moves around the screen and not just teleport. Then our main component just keeps creating new flying buttons, adding a new one every second. There's also a header at the top, just so we can keep track of how many wild buttons we put out there. Now, of course, one button won't crash an app, so we need more than just one. We need a lot of buttons. Surprisingly enough, it seems to need more than just 100. Let's keep adding more. I honestly didn't think it would go this far. Look at this masterpiece. More than 200 buttons roaming freely.
They're moving in herds.
Isn't it beautiful? Alright, we got a breaking record of 251 flying buttons before it all crashed and burned. Not too bad. Let's move to our next experiment. We know that GIFs usually consume lots of energy, especially if you have quite a few on one screen. Today, I want to create an infinite list of GIFs, at least till the end of my phone's memory. For that, I am using the great Giphy API, where I'll fetch all the trending images from. Now, how about creating a list of, let's say, 10 GIFs?
A few moments later.
This time, it felt like slowly seeing my phone dying. That isn't a good feeling at all. But alright, now we know that it crashed after about 2750 GIFs. I didn't think it would still manage to get hundreds of these, so that's quite impressive. Anyways, we have one more experiment for today, so buckle up. To be honest with you, I kind of like mixing animation with chaos from our first experiment with buttons. Also, I'm not quite satisfied with how fast it crashes, and for this last one, I really want something that crashes much faster. So what if this time we were playing with shapes? We can make squares, circles, rectangles that all randomly rotate in every direction. Now, because you might say I'm just trying to entertain and not keeping this a learning material enough, here's some code. I have a shape component that gets random width, height and color when created, and then I animate three different animated values in random ways, top, left and rotation. I then use these three for my transforms that are just interpolating the value to something that makes the whole shape moving all around. Anyways, back to the real experiment. We'll begin with a mirror batch of 100 shapes to get easy on the phone, and we'll slowly increase that number every second. Building up. Actually, it's in these moments that I realized that I've never had so much fun with React Native. And it crashed. After 168 shapes, that's not too bad. It went pretty quickly this time, actually. Okay, I think we can call it success. Maybe next time. I think this was enough chaos for today. Remember to subscribe for hopefully more serious videos than this one. Thanks for watching and see you next time.